Live from New York, it's Trivia Night! How you doing, everybody? Welcome! How's your summer going? How you been? I'm so excited to see you again. I haven't seen you. I feel like I see you guys like once a week. It's my favorite day. I'm looking for. I feel like I'm like your stepdad, right? Is that weird? That's weird. Well, I'm the weirdo with the beardo. My name's Tyler Fisher. You can follow me right here. The first two to follow me tonight on each platform, I send you a personalized impression video. That's right. Welcome to HQ. It is SNL night here on HQ. Who's excited? Saturday Night Live, the first 15. We are live right now, about 10 minutes from SNL. So, That's pretty cool.
I can see Russia from my house.
Party on, Wink.
Party on, girl.
Who could that be, boys and girls?
Sean Connery, just pick a category.
All right, not so fast, Trebek.
El Nino is Spanish for the Nino.
You know how to play, right? Right? I ask you a series of questions. You have 10 seconds to tap your answer. Get a question right, you move on, get all the questions right, and you win the jackpot. And the jackpot tonight is, ready for this, $240,000. That's enough to buy Will Ferrell for a weekend, probably, huh? Someone almost got it on Monday. Question 27. Will you get to question 30 tonight? That's just one of the prizes we have up for grabs tonight. Answer question 11 tonight and you will have the option to cash out or keep playing. Same deal at Q's 15, 18, 21. That means more chances to win. Who doesn't love that? We are making it rain tonight. That's right. You might have heard by now, season 4 is coming to a close. Yes, this Sunday at 9 p.m. is the season 4. We have some big surprises in store, though, for that game, so stay tuned. Stay tuned. And to celebrate season 4 finale, we are bringing back the Champions Game. That's right. If you win any game of trivia or words this week, you will be invited to play an exclusive game this Sunday at 8 o'clock Eastern Time. Yes, if you cash out during any question with the prize during trivia this week, that means you're a winner and you will be invited to the Champions Game. So let's focus tonight. This is big. Season 5 is going to kick off the next day! Yes, we don't wait around here. We got money to give out. We've got new features, prizes, extra stuff. I might shave, who knows? What does that mean? You have to play Monday to find out. 9 o'clock. Woo! I'm nervous. Oh, and have you heard the news about Extra Lives? This week, you can now use Extra Lives through question 17. Pick some up right now if you see them on your screen. You can use up to 3 of them every game. You can also buy extra lives throughout the game by tapping on the little heart icon below. Just don't forget, you cannot use one on a question with a prize. Alrighty, you got that? All right, as you know, it's SNL night, and I mentioned it because I'm so excited. It's probably the reason I'm a comedian. So, there's so many great sketches and characters. Well, who's your favorite? Tell me in the chat your favorite characters, your favorite sketches. Spit them out. Let me know what they are. And because I love it so much, I am going to have you guys pick one sketch, and I'm going to reenact part of it. So I'm going to ask you which one that you guys want to see. I asked you on Twitter today, so here we go. Let's see. All right, so Harry Carey, Will Ferrell, Van Down by the River, or Wayne's World? Which one do you guys want to see me do right now? It's up to you. Whew! All right, what'd you choose? Which one do you guys want to see me do? We got Wayne's World. All right, here we go. All right, so I'm gonna do a little Garth for you here. Schwing, schwing, we're not worthy. Whoa, whoa. All right, you know what? Do we have extra time? All right, we're gonna do one more. We'll do Van Down by the River. Here we go. All right, Wladdy freaking da. We've used ourselves a writer here. You're not gonna be using your papers for writing, but for rolling doobies in a van down by the river. Let's play. All right, do you guys like to play? I like to play. It's time for question one. Let's get into it. Here we go. Q1. The first sketch of an SNL episode is usually about what? Politics, robots, or car chases? First sketch. The opening sketch. Politics, robots. All right, if car chases and robots were in the news, they might open with those, but usually the cold open is where SNL tackles the political news of the week. Give me political, 197,000. You're opening this game with a win on Q1. Nice job, that's right.
Okay, very smart, okay? Not as smart as me, but pretty smart. Moving on to Q2, okay, Q2.
Guys, if you want to multiply your points during tonight's game, get a point multiplier, buy them right now if you see them on your screen. You earn points for every question you answer right. Points help you reach new levels. Levels give you free passes on questions. And if you aren't on a level 10 already, this is your shot to get there for season 4 finale this Sunday. And that makes you closer to the moolah. Big, big moolah. Here we go. Q12. We're live. Q2. Sorry. Hey, we're live. Hey, that's why everyone screws up on SNL. We do it here too. Q. Which of these people was the first Weekend Update host? Was it Jerry Lewis, Chevy Chase, or Lenny Bruce? The first Weekend Update. That's where they go over the news, the middle of the show. All right, well, I'd love to see Jerry Lewis or Lenny Bruce host Update. That'd be crazy. The correct answer here is Chevy Chase.
And now, Weekend Update with Chevy Chase.
Oh, look at him there. He hasn't changed a bit. Who tapped Chevy? Over 194,000. Saturday Night Live heads. That's right. Nice job. You're moving on to Q3. We are Chevy chasing that jackpot. Let's go. Let's get ready for question number 3. What comedian famously co-wrote Stefan with Bill Hader? Was it Adam McKay, Seth Meyers, or John Mulaney? Co-wrote Stefan, hilarious character. All right, you might know the story, but this comic would often change the specifics on the cue cards before filming, inevitably causing Hader to break.
Hi.
Hi.
I'm Stefan.
Yeah, I know who you are.
And who was it? It was Mr. Sir John Mulaney. John Mulaney changing those cue cards. Over 118,000 are moving on to Q4. I'm calling it a little savage because we lost. It was a big chunk. We lost a big chunk. All right, guys. I love Seth Meyers, too. It always looks like he's being robbed, doesn't he? All right. And now a closer look. Don't shoot me. Closer look to Q4 here. What happens to this character after scientists unfreeze him?
I'm a caveman and I'm frightened by your strange flying machine.
Starts a blues band, goes to law school, has a hot tub talk show. After they unfreeze him, start a band, go to law school, have a hot tub talk show. He's just a simple caveman, but he's also a lawyer. That's right. A lawyer. Who knows the law? Over 151,000 of you. You know your laws. Moving on to Q5. That's right. Did you know who that actor was? Tell me in the chat right now. Who was it? Phil Hartman. Rest in peace. One of the best cast members ever. Here we are already on Q5. Who is this character?
So approximately, or average, roughly, how many cigarettes does this beaver smoke in a day?
Is it Brian Fellow, Spoonie Love, or Astronaut Jones? Who was that? That's a throwback. I don't know, probably mid-90s perhaps. Who was it? If you tapped Spoonie Love, nope, because it's Brian Fellow, baby. The old Brian Fellow. Over 152,000 fellowing up. Moving on to Q6, closer to that $240,000. That's right, and that was Tracy Morgan. There'd be no Mark Wahlberg talks to animals without that guy. So, you guys want to see my Tracy Morgan impression? Nope, we're out of time. It was very good, but we're moving on. We got money here. Q6. Which of these 80s performers has a memorable guest role in a Lonely Island digital short? Phil Collins, Michael Bolton, or George Michael? Made an appearance in this hilarious, hilarious song. Our writer Jamie's personal favorite, Lonely Island digital short, Jack Sparrow featuring the 80s legend, Mr. Michael Bolton. If you tap Michael Bolton, you're, let's see, here he is. Show me Bolton. How many people? How many people? Over 146,000 of you are Bolton on to cue number 7. That's right, the Jester of Tortuga. And we got a couple more until we got some money on the line. So stay with me here. Stay with me. Let's go. Cue 7. What is the real last name of the two wild and crazy guys? Is it Svoboda? Is it Festrunk or Dvorak? Dvorak. You know these guys. Look, it's called trivia for a reason. Their last name is Festrunk. That's right. They are the swinging crazy Festrunk brothers.
Let's catch some rays. You and what army?
How many wild and crazy trivia players just got that correct? Over 102,000. Man, you guys watch SNL. You know your stuff. Actually, this is true. Matt Richards and I, we dress up like the wild and crazy guys every Friday, and we don't use pickup lines. We just ask women trivia questions until they walk away. So come join us sometime. Here we are, Q8. As advised in its commercial, which of these should you not do to the happy fun ball? Get it wet, throw it, or taunt it? Don't do this to the Happy Fun Ball. It's a children's toy, but it was also used as a weapon in the Gulf War, so watch out, okay? And definitely do not taunt that little baby. Don't taunt it. Over 114,000 people are moving on to Q9. Nice job. I'm gonna taunt you guys, huh? You guys want some money? Do you? Do you? All right, let's go. Question number 9. The Tom Brokaw pre-tape sketch was originally written for what show? The Dana Carvey Show, the Ben Stiller Show, or Mr. Show? Originally written for which one of those? Okay, if it helps you remember who played Brokaw in the classic sketch, it was Dana Carvey. Take a look here.
Tragedy today as former President Gerald Ford was eaten by wolves. He was delicious.
So, of course, that sketch was written for none other than the Dana Carvey Show. Who knows that? That's an obscure, nice, over 101,000. That show did not live very long. It was actually, that sketch was, the whole show was canceled. People say I look like Dana Carvey. I don't know. Well, isn't that special? Who says it? Satan? Perhaps? Q10. Maybe I look like him. Question number 10. Who was the pitchman for Old Glory Insurance? Is it Sam Waterston, Jerry Orbach, or Jeremy Sisto? The pitchman for Old Glory Insurance. There's nothing like the soothing voice of a Law & Order actor to get you to buy almost everything. This Law & Order guy is Sam Waterston. Sam Waterston, over 95,000. Just got that right. Man, I'm feeling good. I think we're gonna get there tonight. You guys are sticking with it. And then on the next question, remember, the next question, you have the chance to take money or stick around for that 240,000. Remember, someone got to question 27. Are you guys ready? All right, let's do it. Come on. Who does not visibly speak in this sketch?
Let me tell you Mickey specials today. We've got steak and eggs served with some home fries and Mickey waffles.
Woo! I love me some steak and eggs.
Is it Amy Poehler, Lindsay Lohan, or Kenan Thompson? Who's not speaking in that sketch? Amy Poehler, Lindsay Lohan, or Mr. Kenan Thompson? Well, Jimmy Fallon giggles first, obviously. He laughs in everyone. But Kenan is a pro. All the way through. That's right, Mr. Kenan. Oh, guys, no, savage! We lost over 75,000 of you, but 30,000 are still in. You could buy back in with an extra life, all right? All the way up to Q17 tonight, so that's good. Here we go. What are we offering? What are we offering? We are offering 7 cents to 30,140 players. Are you gonna take that 7 cents and walk away? Or are you gonna stick around for that $240,000? What are you gonna do? Can't wait to see what you guys decided. Who took the money? Who took the money? 7,395 players chose to take that 7 cents. Congratulations, guys. You're winners. 22,000 still in the game. Here we go. Four questions until another prize. We're on Q12. What guest host plays the daughter in this classic sketch?
I just assume that Jeff
I would love to finish one damn story.
Your stories are lame, Dad.
You don't talk to me like that.
Shut.
Is it Reese Witherspoon, Michelle Geller, or Kristen Dunst? The guest host in that video, who was it, Reese, Sarah, or Kristen? I drive a Dodge Stratus! The daughter in that dysfunctional family is Buffy herself. We're talking about Sarah Michelle Geller. 22,000. Nice. Almost all of you got that correct. Hey, you'll be able to buy like a fleet of Dodge Stratuses if you win, huh? Here we go. Nice job. We're moving on to Q13. Who was a host of the Meet Your Second Wife game show sketch? Kenan Thompson, Amy Poehler, or Kate McKinnon? That sounds interesting. Meet Your Second Wife game show sketch. Co-hosting this savage sketch with Tina Fey, who is also thought to have written it. The answer here is Miss Beautiful Funny Amy Poehler. I'm taking a poll. 18,904. Got it correct. Nice job. Man, you guys are killing it here. Kenan, of course, he's been on for, what, 37 years? So maybe they can give somebody else a chance on the show. Lauren, here we go. Cue number 14. In his first SNL hosting gig after getting fired from the show, what did Norm Macdonald say was the reason he got canned? Not funny, clashes with Lauren, or his O.J. Simpson jokes? Love this guy. In this classic SNL monologue, Norm Macdonald talks about how he went from being fired from the show for not being funny to being funny enough to host and figuring out that it was because the show sucked now. Ha! Norm, that's right. Oh, guys, savage baby. We lost 13,000 right there. The 5,000 got it correct. Don't forget, hey, we're on 14. You could still buy back in. Get that extra life. And the next question, we are offering you guys some more money. Here we go. Let's focus. We got money on the line, baby. Question 15. On a Black Jeopardy sketch, Tom Hanks' character correctly solves a clue about which of these? Thin women, packet drawer, dog bites. Skinny women could do this for you. What is not a damn thing? Mr. Tom Hanks, Hicks' character, runs the board, and can you believe that this was the same ep as David S. Pumpkins? The classic? We're talking thin women. Show me thin women. 3,117 still in the game, but that was a brutal one. We lost over 7,000 of you. Sorry to see you go, but good news. You could still buy back in. That's right. And we are offering, nope, not on this one, but we are offering 97 cents to 3,117 players. What are you going to do, guys? You're going to take that almost buck and walk away. You're sticking around the chance for almost $250,000. What did you decide to do? Let's see. Let's see. What did you decide to do? 858 players chose to take that dollar. Congrats to those winners. Over 2,000 still in the game. Three questions until another prize. So let's get these three right and get some more cash. Question 16, guys. That was the last SNL question for the night. I want to thank the band. I want to thank Sting, Lauren. Thank you, guys. Congrats to everybody who answered all 15 correctly. Now it's time to move on to the general knowledge portion of the game. You guys know general knowledge things, don't you? Q16. According to the Tour de France, the leading rider's jersey takes its color from which of these? Food, newspaper, or car? Tour de France. The Tour de France. It was the first awarded in 1919 to make the race leader stand out, and the yellow color was chosen because the pages of the race sponsor's magazine, Le Auto, were yellow. We're talking about a newspaper here. 452, but we lost a big chunk of you guys. Brutal. You got another chance to buy back in up until 17. So you got one more chance. Here we go. Nice job. Here we are. We're moving on to Question 17 is the last chance to get an extra life. Get them now. Get them while they're hot. Here we go. Question 17. Which of these people became a billionaire at the youngest age? Steve Ballmer, Michael Bloomberg, or Warren Buffett? This is hard to see how much money these people made. All right, according to the Spectator Index, Ballmer became a billionaire at age 38. Wow, Steve Ballmer. Who wants to be moving closer to becoming a billionaire? Let's see how many people got Ballmer. Over 600 of you. Nice job. 600. You guys are, you invest that 240, couple years, you get $1 billion. Easy. Next question. We got money. We're throwing money at you here for Q18. So you're going to take it? Are you going to stick around? Let's find out. Here we go. Of these three TV shows, which has the highest rated final episode on IMDb.com? The Wire, The Sopranos, or Mad Men? Highest rated episode, highest rated. All right, for their first respective final episodes, The Wire has an 8.8, Sopranos a 9.1, but Mad Men has a 9.3. If you tapped Mad Men, nice, 230 sticks still in the game at question 18. We can do this. Let's see how much money are we offering. We're offering $8.52 to 235 players. Not bad. Almost $10. Are you gonna take that 852 and head out now, or are you gonna stick around for 240,000? Who's got the confidence that they're gonna win that jackpot? 159 players chose to take 852. Congrats to you guys. Nice job. You made it far. 75 still playing. Woo! All right, it's getting hot in here. Let's move on. Here we go. Question 19. Of these countries, which does the UN predict will have the highest population in the year 2050? Japan, Thailand, or Vietnam? The highest population. Here we go. According to 2019 UN predictions, Vietnam will have the population of 109 million. That's right. Vietnam, 109 million, 25 still in the game. Nice job. Nice job. Japan will have 105, Thailand 66, and New York City. New York City is kind of like the weather. When it's like 98, but it feels like 100, we have 8 million, it feels like 300 billion. So here we go. Moving on to question 20. In an ad for its ThinkPad device, which of these did IBM claim was its father? Thomas Edison, Maserati, or mainframe? Who's your daddy? Who's your daddy, IBM? Its mother was a mainframe, and its father was a Maserati. That's right. Its father was a seven people. Namaste. Nice job. We got seven left in the game. We are whittling down. Seven people, one for each day of the week. Next question. Guys, you made it, because we're offering some more money right here. This is a big one. You can win some major cash on Q21. Here we go. Everybody breathe. Whew. The singer of Living on a Prayer made his professional debut on a song about what? Star Wars character, the docs, or learning the ABCs? You know this song, Living on a Prayer. All right, so John Bon Jovi, as he was known at the time, sang lead vocals on a song called R2-D2, We Wish You a Merry Christmas. Of course, R2-D2 is from Star Wars. Who tapped it? One! We got one left in the game. Congrats, nice job. Let's see, how much are we offering this one person? We are offering you, single player, $1,500. What are you gonna do? Do we know who it is? We're gonna try to find out who we're talking to right now. Guys, let's give him some love in the chat right now. $1,500 on the line. And Shadow Fan took the $1,500. Congrats, brother or sister. Congratulations. Thank you. All right, Shadow fans, show them some love. I'm so proud of all of you guys, all right? Congrats to all the winners. Congrats to everybody who made it to a new level. Thank you so much for playing with me. I've been your host, Tyler Fisher. You can follow me right here on all the socials. Stick around. It's comedy night on HQ Words with Anna. It's coming up next. Stick around. Have a great night.